Well, welcome to another epic RV trip. For this trip, we decided to take a trip to Mt Rushmore and visit Yellowstone in Wyoming. It's a long drive. The trip is about over 2,000 miles. So our first stop was Ely, Nevada. One of the great things about RVing is that you can park almost anywhere, and there's a lot of boondocking areas that you can actually park your RV. Now, for those that are just starting or beginning, Flying J is always a great place to park and for free and spend the night over. But you know, when you do park in Flying J's, one of the things that I would advise you to do is to look ahead. Make sure that the Flying J actually has a parking area for RV. I mean, Flying J's do have parking area for trucks, but a lot of times truckers really, really don't like it when you take up their parking spaces. So, I mean, once you park there, they don't care. Really, it doesn't really matter to them, but it's also comes with the noises too, because the truck and truckers always has their generators and their engine on, so it's hard to sleep with all those noise going outside. But here we are eating burger for dinner. I have turkey burgers. So you can see this U-Haul. This guy saw us cooking, and he just decided to go into his U-Haul, took out a chair and sit out in front, you know, while we were cooking dinner. It's really hilarious. It was about like 11 o'clock at night when we got to Ely, Nevada. Who would have thought that Nevada was such a big state, huh?
More turkey burger.
Yeah, my wife wanted me to eat those two turkey burgers, but I had enough. I think one was enough for me. That's something with dieting, I tell you.
Turkey burger, actually, it's really, really good. Hi. Say hi, guys.
Just so that you guys know, the RV place does have a bunk bed, so there's, you're looking at the master bedroom bed, the dinette and the sofa also turns to bed. Hey, so yeah, we definitely have lots of room for at least 10 people in this RV. Here we are at the Salt Lake. Now I gotta warn you guys, one of the things that we failed to do was pay attention to the wind. If I knew that it was this windy, I would have not gone through Salt Lake City. But it was too late, because the route took us to Salt Lake City. The wind, there was a wind warning that was traveling 44 to 45 miles per hour. Boy, you know, driving down a Class A RV down the road at this type of the kind of wind, it was really tough. Don't know how truckers does it. Maybe it's different for RVs. But my car was being thrashed back and forth, side to side. I was really nervous. I had to drive, you know, around 60 miles per hour, even though the speed limit was 70 to 75 miles per hour. And then once we passed Salt Lake City, right about an hour outside of Salt Lake City, we came upon this rest stop. This gorgeous lake just pop out from nowhere. It was just a surprise. It was still windy, though. But I was glad, though, you know, that, you know, we're getting to the mountain ranges, where where hopefully the wind will die down a little bit. And finally, about, again, midnight. One entire day of driving nonstop, we finally arrive at the Custer RV Park, which is 30 minutes away from Mount Rushmore. I would not believe, I was thinking that this park was so close to the city we would see light, but it was pretty much dead outside. I mean, there's total darkness. It was hard to park the RV, by the way, in the middle of the night and it's dark. But one of the things I learned, you know, while RVing, is you learn some tricks to park your RV, you know. because sometimes the parking are not very level. You have to, you know, level your vehicles. So I learned that, you know, instead of guessing where the part where my car would be most likely be able to level would be to turn on the leveler itself, right? I just learned that. So, you know, while driving, I should turn on the leveler and level meters, and the meters be able to tell me where I should be able to easily level the vehicles. You know, it took us 5 or 10 minutes to drive back the car and maneuver the vehicles just to get to level. But the plugging in all the electricities and the tank waters, it was pretty easy. It took less than 5 minutes, even though it was in the dark. Here we have a dinner for it as dry aged beef. My brother, I think, believe had it for 23 days or maybe 35 days, I forgot. It was actually pretty good. You guys know I'm not supposed to eat beef, but I ate it anyway. Here? Ah, thank goodness though. Last night, I was worried though, because when we arrived here, it was raining hard. There was a storm in the distance, and I thought it was gonna rain because, you know, I did look at the forecast, and the forecast did say sunny, but I was afraid it was just gonna rain and it was gonna destroy our whole entire trip. We would be coming to Mount Rushmore for nothing. But this morning, there's a clear blue sky, and it's a beautiful landscape. Never thought South Dakota would be this beautiful. I always thought that South Dakota would be all field, no trees, mostly desert. But look, this park has some teepees, has some tents, and it has some old western cottages. It's a pretty new RV park, by the way. We were lucky though, because every other RV park was pretty full. This one was new, and according to the hostess, not a lot of people know about this RV park. It just recently opened. Now, folks, if you guys ever come visit this RV park or Custer's, don't believe Google about rental vehicles. It was a rental vehicle place that was out of business for 5 years and was still showing up. And the cell phone doesn't work either, so I kind of found that out. And I ended up having to call one of the RV place and the hotel place. And I was not about to go to Rapid City, which is about an hour away, just to rent a car. So I looked around, and one of the hotel and told me that, you know, they had this guy that was renting out vehicles, but it was unofficial. So I gave him a call, and of course he has the vehicles available. It's a good thing that nobody knows about it. Otherwise, he might not have been able to rent a car at a short notice. As you can see, it's really beautiful. Sorry about the pictures too, by the way. I'm an amateur, a drone pilot, so kind of shaky. I should cut some of these out, but hope you guys don't get sick for watching it. This is during COVID, so as you can see, you know, I was surprised when we got here. South Dakota was not on lockdown at all. There were multiple people that was gathering together. I mean, there was a load of people partying at this RV park. I guess the only people that weren't partying was us. One thing that I do know about these cottages, it must not get hot up here, because none of these cottages has air conditioning inside. So the other thing is they don't have heaters too as well. So here's my fat self. I'll take a little selfie while I'm out flying the drone. Of course, the wife is doing breakfast. She's making breakfast. We have some turkey bacon and egg cooking. so. As you can see, trying to sneak up on her. I think I was, this part I was having difficult trying to get the drone between the, going between the trees and the RV without hitting anything. That's one of the biggest challenge of flying a drone. Sometimes your left can mean your right. Your right can mean your left. Rotating can mean another arrow, and before you know it, your drone went the other opposite directions. Still gotta learn the instruments and how to control it. Practicing. Hopefully next pictures will look nice. She was so afraid that the blade of the drone's gonna hit her or fall on top of the pan. She was like waiting, get out of here. So, beautiful weather though. It was not hot, it was not cold. Perfect hiking. Didn't think South Dakota was this gorgeous though. Here we are, finally at Mount Rushmore. Surprised, we were there early though, thinking that there was going to be a lot of people, but there wasn't any people there. And there's the Mount Rushmore monuments. I did show a video of the hike that we did. Unfortunately, it was just a small little loop. So we decided to take a trip to Crazy Horse Monument. I understand that this monument has been is being built 100 years ago. And then in South Dakota, you can't not visit the Needle Highway. So, very beautiful place to visit the Needle Highway. Just don't bring your RV because it will not fit on this highway. Like this right here. This is the reason why we had to rent a car. Because the RV will not fit through this passage. There was some crazy RV driver that drove up there, but I don't know how they would make a U-turn. Now this is Deadwood, by the way. So there were some casinos there. And also, we decided to go ziplining in Deadwood as well. I was still pretty hurt that day because of the roller coaster ride that we had. Not in this picture, by the way. Then again, I have to confess, I was just plainly afraid of heights. And the long walk up. So me and my brother, we stayed behind while my wife and his wife decided to race each other. There was not a lot of people. I was surprised. So. This is probably the last day before we head to Yellowstone. And I tell you, the trip to Yellowstone was crazy too. Because as soon as we left Mount Rushmore, it started to rain. There was storm in the horizons as we crossed across Mountain Montana into Wyoming. At first I thought it was going to snow. I was worried that, you know, it might hit the snow, but luckily, I look at the weather forecast, it was just a small little snow, a little bit of rain, nothing else. Here we are. Before we hit the Yellowstone, we did enter North Dakota and visit the Badlands in North Dakota. Little rest stop. Instead of going to the state park, we just took the rest stop and view it. And here, finally here at Yellowstone, this is the north entrance. Now, if you guys want to see this arch, you have to go through the north entrance, which is from Montana to Wyoming. Although there was no car passing in this entrance, we thought it would just be a good idea to drive through the entrance, just for experience. This here is Mammoth Geysers. The last time I hear all of these mountains in the background has beautiful pictures, crazy colors. Here's a field of geysers. And find any Yellowstones, be sure to visit the buffaloes. And the last but not least, we waited for about an hour and a half for this in the freezing temperatures just to see Old Faithful explode. So enjoy. I hope that you guys liked the video. I know next time I should put myself in there more so you can actually see who I am, right? Instead of just being the voice. Yeah. By the way, it was all worth sitting in the freezing temperatures just waiting for a Faithful to explode. I don't know what's up with that, huh? Maybe it's just the excitement of looking at something. But this is like a 10-15 minute show, that's it. It happens almost every hour or so. So well, this is it. Be sure that if you guys like the channel, please subscribe, like, and I'll bring you some more adventures in the near future.